Hi everybody. Since the last video that I did about the adult heel pain, I've received some questions about if it's the same for kids. There's some kids with heel pain, and the answer is no. There are two different entities. For the adult, we have the pain on the bottom of the heel right here, marked in red. For kids, I marked it in black. There's a growth plate in the heel bone right here that will fuse about 16 to 18 years of age in a child, and we'll go over that. Pediatric heel pain is more an inflammation of this growth plate rather than the bottom right here, where the inflammation is for adults usually. So kids is growth plate inflammation. So the five things you need to know about pediatric heel pain. Number one, it starts about 10 years, when kids are about 10 to 15 years old, when they start being active. Sports most commonly seen are soccer, basketball, martial arts, any sport that requires a lot of jumping and running. Second thing you need to know about pediatric heel pain is high impact sports does seem to aggravate this this condition. So if you have a child with pediatric heel pain, definitely a little bit of rest, ice, and elevation and compression would help. I'll go over some of the treatment plans for this later on in the video. Number three, patient has pain during sports. Let's say your child playing soccer, they're running on the field and they limp throughout the game, or they come off the court limping or crying. That's something that really needs to be addressed. Don't push it off to the side. The fourth thing you need to know about pediatric heel pain is your child is going to have a significant limp from this. They're going to complain. They're going to say, hey, my heel hurts. Don't ignore that. Please get that addressed. And number five, what you need to know is supportive shoes are very important. I know a lot of these Nike running shoes nowadays are becoming lighter and lighter. They're meant for runners, not for everyday sport usage. For a developing child, or even for an adult for everyday usage. Again, their running shoes are made to be light and flexible, not meant to be used for everyday exercise or training. Heel cups are very important when patients have heel pain too for a child. Often a child will present with pain or toe walking from the parents. The parents will say, hey, my child has pain in the heel and walking on the toes. Typically, the child will have pain upon squeezing. Right here, this is the foot model right here. Again, I marked the growth plate on this model for you. Typically, if you put your finger along the growth plate and you do a squeeze and the child hurts, that's usually a growth plate inflammation. So the first thing I tell the parents is, number one, let me see the shoes. The shoes need to be supportive. Second thing is, I need to stretch out the Achilles tendon and get the physical therapy. Physical therapy is ordered, and it will help significantly with this condition. Basically, what happens is, if you look at this model right here, you have the Achilles tendon, and then you have the plantar fascia pulling on that growth plate. The growth plate will be right about here. So you get one pulling up and one pulling down. This growth plate gets inflamed. Sometime on the x-ray, we can see that if it's been chronic. And unfortunately, a lot of time when I see these patients, they've been suffering for a few months. So don't let your child suffer with this. It can be treated really easily. The first thing we do, check out the shoes. We get them some heel inserts. The heel inserts, a little gel cushion. Immediately, the child can feel 80 to 90 or even 100% better just with that. But stretching the Achilles tendon is very important. So Achilles tendon exercises are very important for this condition. I can't overemphasize this. And custom orthotic therapy can be very helpful in this condition also to prevent the flattening of the arch or prevent additional pull from the Achilles tendon or the plantar fascia. Support is very important. Remember, proper shoe wear, as the industry goes with minimalist shoes, your child, the groin bones and growth plates need some supportive shoes. Visit a reputable shoe store with a measure your child, and that should take care of that condition. Definitely, if stretching and better shoes and heel cup does not help the relieve your child's symptoms, definitely see a podiatrist and get an x-ray, get an evaluation. The longer your child suffers with this, the harder it is to go away. So there's no need to suffer. Have your child see a podiatrist. Thank you.